my presentation. Connected to Zoom.
The laptop volume should be.
Network, I didn't log in. Is it here? I don't need to be connected to the Zoom, right?
No, I think it will come.
Ah. Email, I've sent it.
Thank you. I'm
Prabhu, am I audible to the Zoom audience? Hare Krishna, am I audible? Hare Krishna for the Zoom audience.
Yes, Prabhu.
I'm audible to all the Zoom audience online. Not clear. Not clear.
It's echoing. Nothing to do with this. It's echoing. The ping was there last time.
Okay.
It's same ping issue.
Is it echoing? ओम ज्ञान तिमिरम ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायण नमस्कृत्यम नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं पार्वतसेव्या भवतीरुत्तमश्लोके भक्ति भवति नैषकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे Prabhu, is that the sound is sorted out or still an issue? Is it because of the mic and this is speaker? Probably this is closer, you can listen to me or something like that. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Okay. So we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 21, entitled Conversation Between Manu and Kardama Muni, Text Number 33. Prabhu, the online audience, how do they see this sloka? Because you are sharing.
We will share from there.
321.33. Maitreya Uvacha Evam Tam Anubhashatah Bhagavan Pratyaksha Jah Jagama Bindu Sharah Sarasvatya Parishrata Maitreya Uvacha एवं तम अनुभाषतः
एवं तम अनुभाषतः
भगवान् प्रत्यक्षजः जगाम बिंदु सरसः सरस्वत्य परिश्रता। मैत्रेय उवाच एवं तम अनुभाषत भगवान् प्रत्यक् अक्षजः जगाम बिंदु सरसः सरस्वत्य परिश्रता। मैत्रेय उवाच मैत्रेय उवाच एवं तम अनुभाष्यत भगवान् प्रत्यक्षजः जगाम बिंदु सरसः सरस्वत्या परिश्रुतात्। मैत्रेय उवाच एवं तम अनुभाष्यत भगवान् प्रत्यक्षजः राम सिंधु सरसः मैत्रेय उवाच एवं तम अनुभाषक भगवान् प्रत्यक्षजः जगाम बिंदु सरसः सरस्वत्या परिश्रुता। Please repeat after me word by word. Maitreya Uvacha. The great sage Maitreya said, Evam, thus, tam, to him, Anubhashya, having spoken, Ata, then, Bhagavan, the Lord, Pratyak, directly, Aksha, by senses, Jaha, who is perceived, Jagama, went away, Bindu Sarasaha, from Lake Bindu Sarovara, Sarasvatya, by the river Saraswati, Parishrita, encircled. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki? Maitreya went on, thus having spoken to Kardama Muni, the Lord who reveals himself only when the senses are in Krishna consciousness, departed from that lake called Bindu Sarovara, which was encircled by the river Saraswati. Purport. One word in this verse is very significant. The Lord is stated here to be Pratyaksha Jaha. He is imperceptible to the material senses, but still he can be seen. This appears to be contradictory. We have material senses, but how can we see the Supreme Lord? He is called Adokshaja, which means that he cannot be seen by the material senses. Akshaja means knowledge perceived by material senses. Because the Lord is not an object that can be understood by speculation with our material senses. He is also called Ajita. He will conquer, but no one can conquer him. What does that mean? Then that still he can be seen. It is explained that no one can hear the transcendental name of Krishna, no one can understand his transcendental form, and no one can assimilate his transcendental pastime. It is not possible. Then how is it possible that he can be seen and understood? When one is trained in devotion service and renders service unto him, gradually one senses are purified of material contamination. When one senses are thus purified, one can understand, one can hear, and so on. The purification of the material senses and perception of the transcendental form, name, and quality of Krishna are combined together in one word, Pratyaksha Jaha, which is used here.
ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देवं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुधपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवां च श्रीरूपं सागरजादां सगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सगण ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितां च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमदे भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामी नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशधारिणे महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिने गौरतिशे नमः हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते गांजन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानो सुदे देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांचा कल्पतरुभ्यश कृपा सिंधुभ्यो च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज फॉर द नित्यम भागवत सेवा आई एम सो प्लीज्ड टू बी हियर with so many devotees and I seek all the Vaishnavas blessing before I speak. Today I referred what our Prabhupada lectures he has given on this topic. So I seek all the Vaishnavas blessing. So the translation, Maitreya went on, thus having spoken to Kardamamuni, the Lord who reveals himself only when the senses are in Krishna consciousness. We can't see Krishna, only our senses are purified in Krishna consciousness. Then we can see the Lord. So this is the purport. Also Prabhupada talks about adho pratyaksha jaha. So this is the same topic I have taken for today. So we'll be discussing about seeing Krishna face to face through the tongue. This is also one of the lecture Prabhupada has given somewhere in London. I don't remember the year. So this is some of the experts are taken from that. So Prabhupada is telling how we can see with our material senses we can't see, but purified senses we can see, especially the tongue. Jivan mukohi jivadu jivhadu sevan mukohi jivhadu. So this is the topic we are going to see, but I know for online audience we've been hearing a fourth canto, so this Sunday we are reading from this third canto, conversation between Manu and Kardama. So I'll just give a quick background before I get on to today's topic, so that you know the background which we are talking about. So there is a conversation between Maitreya and Vidura, and Vidura is asking, please tell me more about this Manu and Kardama, what is happening. So that's where the conversation starts, and Vidura is asking, please tell me more about the lineage of the great Manu. So yesterday I was in one of the hospital, you know, I was waiting in their place. So there is one person talking to his wife. Do you know this girl, relative of, you know, brother of that person, uncle's daughter, sister, you know, something like that. She got married to someone. So similarly, it looks like here our Vidura is asking, Maitreya, please tell me about who is, how many sons this Manu had begotten, how many daughters are there? There are three daughters and, you know, then so many sons like that. So it looks like, you know, talking about the family affairs. So why Bhagavatam talks about and the great rishis talk about it? It's not that it's a family like, you know, the Prajalpa, the other normal karmis to it. This is the great lineage where we can learn. Bhagavatam is all about the examples, life history of the devotees, the great Vaishnavas. Lord Kapila Dev himself appeared in the Devahuti Kardamuni. So we are going to talk about those. So it is completely different. This is transcendental. By hearing this transcendental, if somebody is inclined to talk about the Gramya Kada, you want to know about some family affairs, they can memorize this chart. This is a very complex chart. So you can ask who married to what, Sarmishta married to whom, Devayani married to whom. And now this kind of thing we want to involve, then this is purifying actually. And know what is the teaching of those great personalities. So that's what the conversation going on. After that, Kardama Muni, he was meditating. Then he sees the Lord face to face. Then the Lord said, what do you want? Then he said, I want a girl to marry. So this is another point to be noted. We will always say, Anna Vilesita Shunyam, Jnana Karna Guna Anuvartam, Anukulena Krishnanu Seelanam, Ye Bhakti Ruttama. So we say, we should not have any motive, Jnana, no karma. But you can see here, Kardama Muni asking for a girl. Dhruva Maharaj, he wanted a big kingdom. After seeing Krishna, he was purified. He said, I don't want anything. But still Lord gave. Here, we see Kardama Muni still asking, I need a girl to marry. So it's not because of he wanted a material desire. This is his superiors asking to do his seva. So even if it's a material or spiritual, it's better to go to Krishna. If you go to the other devatas, they might give. If you have Sukriti, but they don't know it is good or bad. But Krishna knows what is good or bad. Even though we are eligible, he may withhold for some time. So we can see from this learning, if there is something obstacle to our life, so Prabhupada always said, my disciples are not feared of Maya, enough afraid of Maya. That's why there might be a fall down. If you have some problem, it is okay to go and pray to Krishna saying that I don't want to fall down because I want to be protected. This is the anartha I have, which I'm not able to overcome. You can pray for devotional service. If somebody is having a critical illness or terminal diseases, he's not able to perform his sadhana, then it's okay, go and pray. It is part of Anabhilashata Shunyam. It's not we should think that, okay, I'm asking for material thing. So there is a difference between what we should ask, what we should not ask. Anything related to bhakti, we are not able to perform, we have anarthas, it's okay to go and talk to Lord, because you might say Paramatma knows everything, why should I pray to him? That's different. So we need to have a personal connection and you can pray to him. When you see the great acharyas, Prahlad Maharaj, when he asked Narsingadev, ask me some boon, he said, I don't want. But he said, I am afraid of material attraction. Then we heard from Srinidhi Govinda Prabhu last week, how this, he was asking Namachar Eridas Thakur, what you want? Sridhar Kolavecha, he was asking, everybody is telling, I want to become a Vaishnava dog or a whatever animal in devotee's family. I want to always serve the Vaishnavas. Or we see Kulashekhar Alwar when he prays, I want only lotus feet of yours. I might go to wherever I want, but I always need to remember your lotus feet. So asking for devotion service, asking to remove the anarthas, asking something you're not able to perform your devotion service, it's okay to ask, pray to the Lord. Because one time Ramanujacharya told his disciple, Kuresha, that he was blinded because he exchanged his guru's cloth in order to avoid Ramanuja then escape from Tamil Nadu. He came to Melkote, Thondanur. That's where he changed to his saffron dress. So the king thought that Kuresha was the person, Ramanuja, and he crucified him and removed his eyes. So he told Ramanuja many a times, go and pray to Varadaraj, get the eyes back. But he didn't go. I mean, when he went, but he didn't pray. Then he said, property of your guru is something damaged. Please go and request to restore that. And when he prayed, he got his eyes. So we think that our body, we are the body. But whenever, as soon as we take initiation, we are belong to the guru and Krishna. So we need to take care of our body. It's part of Krishna's property. It's part of Guru's property. There is nothing wrong in praying in that mode, saying that I'm not able to perform my sadhana, please help me. So that's the lesson we can learn from this Kardama Muni asking a suitable girl for a marriage. So we should not think that it is not a pure devotion service. So with that conversation, we can come to this sloka. Just before this 32nd sloka, and Krishna explains saying that I have already seen a suitable girl for you. Devahuti will come tomorrow or whatever appropriate time. Then you will get married and you also will beget so many children. There are many, so many girls. I also will appear as a Lord Kapila. Then you will be relieved from this. So Krishna gives all this. Then this is the verse which after speaking, the Lord leaves. So here we can see that only purified senses. Dhruva Maharaj purified his senses. Then he was able to see. So here Kardama Muni did penances for a long time, then he able to see the Lord. So Prabhupada is trying to bring the point that only purified senses we can see the Lord. So we can go more into that. So there are, we know that three sources of ways to perceive something, your knowledge. There are various pramanas available. In fact, Jiva Goswami in Tattva Sandarbha gives 10 pramanas which we can do. But we know the primary three of them. One is pratyaksha, seeing directly. Seeing is believing. But our senses not so perfect. You know, we can't see. A dog can listen to a whistle, which is low frequency. And you can see in the glass there is a pencil. It is kind of a broken. It looks like up here, even though it's seeing. So we know this. I will not get into more, but I just want to talk about this. Another one is this anumana. Means we are thinking this could be that, this could be that, like that. So there was one time, there is a conversation happening between one professor and a young student. The professor was, you know, he didn't believe in Christianity. He was atheist. Then he asked all the students, all students today, you know, we will talk about something interesting. And he asked, anyone believes in God? Then all the students, he said, yes, we believe in God. Then the professor started asking, is God is good or bad? Everyone said, obviously God is good. Why are you talking about like that? And then the professor started telling, is God all powerful? Then everybody said, yes, yes, unanimously. Then he said, my brother, he had a cancer. I prayed to the Lord sincerely that let him cure. But he did not cure. If all is God all powerful, is all God is good, why is allowing to suffer the people? So that way God is bad. Then he started, the students were taken back what to respond to the professor. Then second point he asked, okay, how many of you think that there is a Satan or demonic people available? Then student said, yes, yes, there are available. Then he said, who created? Then God created. If God is good, why he created all the evils? We see poverty, somebody is ugly, somebody is having a problem. So why God is all good? Why is he has to do all this thing? Then the students dumbfold, they didn't had any answer. Then further on he went to the professor. Okay, let me ask this. Who has seen God? Have you seen anybody seen God? Have you smelled God? Or at least you heard your God? Anybody touch the God? Then no answer. And so he said, then how are you thinking that there is a God? The student stood up and said, it is based on the faith. Then the professor got really angry, said, what kind of faith you're talking about? Anything needs to be experimented. It should be defined. It should be seen. So we can't see the God. We can't perceive the God. That's why established rules of empirical stable. It is a demonstrative protocol. Science say that there is no God because we can't see that. So the student started replying. There is one brilliant student. He got up and started asking this question. Professor, may I know there is a heat? He said, yes. May I know there is a cold? The professor said, yes. But there is nothing called cold. If there is no heat, then it's called cold. The absence of heat is called cold. There is nothing called clearly concept called cold. Then the professor taken a little back. Then he said, have you seen this electricity? Or have you seen about magnetism? You talk about physics all about talks about magnetism. Have you ever felt it? Have you ever seen it? The professor did not add any answer. He further went on. He said, have you seen any light? Yes. He said, darkness? Yes. But there is nothing called darkness. The absence of light is the darkness. Then he went on asking, saying that, has any one of us in the classroom have seen the brain of the professor? The kid started laughing. Have anybody is perceived or has anybody is touched brains of the professor? He said, no. Then the student said, according to the established rules of empirical, stable, demonstrable protocol, our professor doesn't have a brain. The professor said, you have to believe. Exactly. That's what I'm telling. You should have a faith on something. Otherwise, it was Albert Einstein. So we try to understand the empirical way. That doesn't work. Sabda Pramana is the pure. We know from various sources, cow dung is pure, conch is pure. The distance between sun and earth is defined in already in Hanuman Chalisa. It's brilliant, right? So to quickly see that the four defects, what we have, imperfect senses. So you can see this picture. Can anybody see the first picture? What is that you see? Ours. Okay, what else you see in the same picture? There is a frog. If you tilt the picture horizontally, then you see a frog trying to jump. The next picture, Next picture. Somebody can chat in the Zoom, those who are devotees. You can see there is a rabbit and there is also a duck. Right? Our senses are imperfect. You can't see them. So even small picture like this, we are not able to. My mouse is not moving. Oh, sorry. Okay. Next one. So what do you see here? In the first picture, you can see a lot of animals, horses and birds, but there is no woman, but you can see a face of a lady. And also the second picture, have you noticed any old woman here? The face of a old woman? It's very difficult to digest, but there is a face of a old woman as well as young woman. What I'm trying to convey is in this slideshow that our senses are imperfect. There is a tendency to commit mistake. We will be illusioned and also tendency to cheat. So this, apart from these three main pramanas, sabda pramana is the ultimate. We should rely on the Vedas. So other 10 pramanas quickly I'll talk about. Arsha means it's coming from the lineage of the sages. Some sages, Patanjali, will talk about one philosophy. Another comes with Mimamsa philosophy. Other one talk about various philosophy. They themselves defeat Mayavada philosophy, Sankara philosophy. Then Buddha comes with his own philosophy. We see that it is still not perfect. Then next one is Upamana. Upamana means giving example like that. So person might say, there is a Nilgai in the forest. If you go, it looks like this feature is there. Then you can understand this is the particular animal. The person goes to the forest, he sees the description, he sees a particular object, then he says Upamana, oh, it matches all those features. Then Arthapati means you see a fat person, you don't see him eating in the daytime. What does that mean? He must be eating in the night. That's the interpretation we give. We see a person fat, but he never eats anything in the daytime. So that's called Arthapati. You try to analyze. Abhava means non-existent. This is a special variety of a pratyaksha. In the table, there is no book, which means that I'm not reading, something like that. So absence of something you try to make out. So then Sambhava means you try, let's say there's a Krorpati, you must be Lakpati. So the derivation is that any of you should have more Lakshmi. It's also called Lakpati. So that kind of Anumana giving. Then Atyaha, like, you know, try your traditional, whatever custom we have been following, like that. Then finally comes the chestra, which means that you try to do symbolic movement like this. If you show, it is victory, like that. So those kind of various other pramanas which substitute it can work as another sub pramana to prove that the other things, but out of which all sabda pramana is important. So coming to the next topic, do we really need eyes to see God? Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hrudayeshu vilokayanti yam shama sundaram achintya gunaswarupam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. We see that premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena, we need eyes to see the Lord, special eyes. We know this Mayapur, Rajapur, there is a Jagannath. We know that how they appeared. There is a person called Jagadish Ganguly. He was a blind, he could become old. He could not able to go to Puri. Then he was intensely praying to the Lord that I'm not able to come. Then the Lord himself appeared here. He told him, when you go and take bath in the Ganges, there will be a log of wood will be touching, then you will restore your vision. Then you take it to a person who is leper. He is having fingers all not in proper shape. He is fuzzing and, you know, oozing out of the blood. You ask him to carve my deities. So imagine, so the seeing the Lord, he was a blind, but his devotion, he could able to invoke the Lord. He can able to see the Lord. So it is not necessarily that, you know, we need to have, even though we have eyes, we can't see the God. The second example is that we can see from Arjuna seeing the universal form. Divyam tadami te chakshushaha. So he is telling Lord, I will give you a special eyes to see you. Otherwise you can't see me. Then there is a wonderful story of Bilwa Mangal Thakur. He was a blind and Krishna is always sitting with him serving game. So from these examples, we see that, you know, wonderful prayers, what Vilva Mangal Thakur writes, Vraje Prasitam Navanita Choram Gopanganam Chadukula Choram Aneka Janmarchita Papa Choram Choragarahanyam Purusham Namami. In that he prays, Karagrahe vasasada hirdaye madiye mad bhakti pashadrida vandana nishchalasan tvam krishna he pralaya koti satantrepi sarvasya chura hirdayam nahi moshayami. He said, I bound you in my heart, you might run away from me. Krishna was running away. I said, I put it in my jail of my heart, how will you run away now? Look at the devotion. So there is no eyes really. These are the blind or so-called blind, but they are able to capture the Lord in their heart. So, and also when we come to the deities, when we see the deities, we need to open our eyes and look at their beauties, how they are dressed today, what color they are wearing, what kind of ornament they are wearing. One time I learned this lesson very lesson in Tirupati. It's the first time I'm going after I grown up 18, 16 years after that. Of course, I've gone many times, but this is the time I'm going alone. Then I was standing in the queue for 6-7 hours. Then I have this bad habit of in front of standing the Lord and praying intensely, closing eyes. So in front of the Lord, I started doing it. Next time I saw, I was outside the darshan. I didn't see the Lord. So it doesn't work in Tirupati. So we have to see the Lord, capture the beauty of the Lord. Then you can close eye and start meditating in our heart. So when we see, come to see the deities, it is that deity is trying to see us. In Ramanujacharya Sampradaya, we see that one of the Acharya, he is a sannyasi. But Ranganatha used to come around the temple. Then he would immediately put on very nice silk cloth, as opulent as that, and he would come before the Lord. So everybody would used to criticize him. See, this sannyasi is supposed to be simple, humble, saffron dress. He is wearing so much opulent dress. Then when they asked the disciples, what is that meaning? He said, Lord is coming. He want to see me. So we also need to dress it, not opulently, but at least neatly, so that we present it to ourselves for Krishna's pleasure. We come here so that Krishna can see us. It's not that we want to see the Krishna. We can understand through our material blind senses. That's what Prabhupada again and again telling. Unless our senses are purified, we can't see Krishna. There is a wonderful personal realization happened. This is in Melkote. You can see there's a particular person, this Vaishnava, who has been serving many decades. He would climb every day, taking the water, 300 steps. And this happened, the first batch of Bhakti Shastri. I know Prabhu is going to launch the second batch of Bhakti Shastri in our ICC. This happened during our Bhakti Shastri course. We went to Melkote and we were on the particular night, Saturday evening, it was about 6:30 or 7. And we finished our first session and they said, let's go to take darshan of the Lord Narasimhadev. And it was almost 7. They said the temple will close by 7:30. And the devotees started, IFI devotees are started walking, running. They've already reached. And we are elderly. Sorry, I'm not elderly, but still. I'm not able to walk. And we were trying to take the car. I went to the wrong path. Then I was coming back. Then I stopped halfway to the hill and started walking. Then there are a few other devotees along with walking. Then we were discussing. It's so painful to climb so much stairs. Why the Lord is always on the top hill mountain, why you can't be in the certain plane, especially Narasimhadev. Ahobilam, we have to climb Jwalan Narasingha, we have to climb so many steps. Always Narasimhadev is in the so high that we are not able to climb. So we were cribbing and, you know, walking, and we know that the temple is going to close. We're not going to have darshan. So we were anxiety, we were trying to climb, and finally we could able to reach. There I saw something very astonishing, very strange thing which happened. So then we reached, they gave prasadam, we were praying Narasimhaarti. After some time, I was deeply praying to the Lordships. Then suddenly I saw a Vaishnava, the Prohit, who is in charge of the temple. There is one more 60 years old person. So I'm seeing from the behind. So that person was standing, he was talking, he was wearing pant and shirt. The pujari was patting on him back and he was trying to talk. He doesn't look like another Vaishnava, but he looked like normal karmic cloth. And he doesn't look like a normal person. The pujari was very close to him and he was patting him, talking him. Then after some time, I realized this person is blind. A blind person want to take a darshan of the Lord, taking all the effort in the night, and he has a 17-year-old daughter or something, took her help, and he's climbing all the way. and to see the Lord. It's not that he wants to see the Lord. Anyway, we can't see the Lord. It is for the pleasure of the Lord. He wants to go so the Lord can look at his devotees, look at this understanding. Then I was really mind-boggling to see how a person takes. We have a good leg. We know the philosophy. We want to see the Lord. Still, I was cribbing about climbing so many steps. But this person happily comes every, I don't know what frequency he comes, but every time he wants to come and present it to the Lord. So that's really struck. The next day, the sloka started, Nectar of Devotion. Uschaga, Dairyat, Nishchayat. Then I realized, Prabhu, you don't need to tell the purport. I know yesterday what happened. I think they've really told Uschaga, how enthusiastically, Dairyat, this person is climbing every day to see the Lord. So not see the Lord to see him. So we see from various instances on this that with our endeavor, we can't see the Lord. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told, you have to work such a way that the Lord sees you. Like if you want to see the particular manager or CTO of the company, it's a big factory, you may not get audience. But if you do a wonderful job, the person wants to see you. He said, I want to see this person, this worker who has done a wonderful job. Similarly, in our devotion service, we perform our activity, then Krishna will see us. Of course, we need to see his beauty, form, see the ornaments, what he's wearing, start meditating, pastimes of the Lord. When you see the thigh of the Lord, pastime, seeing the lotus feet of the Lord, we can remember the pastime. Like that, we can meditate on that. That remembrance, we can take it and we do that. But actually, Krishna, we have to ensure that we are doing a seva such a way that Krishna sees that. So this is the sloka for the day. This is from the purport, what our purport, Prabhupada has written. So I'd like to repeat. So you can repeat with me this sloka. After that, we can discuss. This will be the today sloka for the day. Atha Shri Krishna Namadi Na Bhavet Grahyam Indriyaha Sevan Mukehi Jivhado Swayam Eva Spruthyataha. So I thought this is the shloka which is for Prabhupada writing Adho Sajjaha. Raja Vidya Raja Gukyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam Pratyaksha Vagamam Dharmyam Susukam Kartum Abhyayam. It is directly perceivable, the devotion service. By performing devotion service only, we can understand the Lord. It's not through our material eyes. One time Prabhupada was listening to his Guru Maharaj Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, but whereas other devotees went for darshan of the deities, then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was heavy. So have you done your exercise for your eyes? When the Guru is speaking, you're not trying to understand. You have to understand, see the Lordship through the ears. Then you are doing simply exercise of your eyes. Similarly, Prabhupada writes here, therefore, material senses cannot appreciate Krishna's holy name, form, qualities and pastimes when a conditioned soul is awakened to Krishna consciousness and renders service by using his tongue to chant the Lord's holy name, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare, and taste the remnants of the Lord food, the tongue purified and one can gradually become understand who Krishna really is. And Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu also, Prabhupada is trying to understand through the blunt material senses, it is not easy to understand. So let us deep dive into this sloka. And after that, we will probably open up for more question and answer discussion on this. So there are two parts to it. One is this seva. So through only seva, devotion service, we can purify our senses. We want to see the God. Then the underlying principle is that Sevan Mukohi Jivhadu, at least by using the tongue, among all the senses, Jiva is the most thing which we need to control. Then we can see the Lord. So that's the theme of the topic today. So we know that Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavan Mam Prabhadyante Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sa Mahatma Surdurlabha. Out of many, many Janmas, a person who understands Krishna, it is very difficult. Because unless you might be a great, Prabhupada writes in the purport, one might be a jnani, one might be realizing a paramatma, astanga yogi, or a Brahman realization. They see bewildered, Brahma got bewildered when we saw that Krishna is eating from mouth of another boy. And Yashoda was putting water on him. Indra got bewildered. What kind of a supreme personality of Godhead is? So that only can be understood when the senses are purified. Another thing is that we can... Sattva. मनुष्याणां सहस्रेषु कश्चित् यदति सिद्धये यदतामपि सिद्धानां कश्चिन् मां वेदि तत्वतः द तत्वतः दि जन्म कर्म च मे दिव्यम्. एक्चुअली कृष्णास बर्थ एंड डेथ इट इज वेरी ट्रांसेंडेंटल. इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस तत्व अनलेस अ पर्सन हैज टेकन मेनी मेनी मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स एंड ट्राई टू डू अ डिवोशन सर्विस ही कैन अंडरस्टैंड. So another example we can see that from this Krishna is talking about bhaktya mam abhijanati. Only by devotional service devotee can understand. Again we see in the Bhagavatam Savipum Sam Parodharma Sloka Adokshaja. Again Prabhupada using it, Krishna's name is another name is Adokshaja. He cannot be understood with material senses. So there are sufficient evidences. We can see that Dhruva Maharaj or let it be Karadvamani, they have penance, meditated, then they purified senses, and then finally they were able to see the Lord. Now the point today I want to highlight is that it's not only the seva itself is not sufficient to see the Lord. It is on the mood on which we perform the seva that is more important than the seva itself. So that's a topic I would like to highlight more. I want to go deep dive into the mood on which we perform the seva. That is stands, of course, seva is important to purify our senses, but just by doing seva alone, we can't see the Lord. It is mood on which we perform this wonderful seva. It's very important. So now out of this seva, we know this, this jiva, tongue is very important. Now there are in ISKCON, we know our ICC, there are many, many, many branches of the departments are there, service department. Somebody is finance department, somebody is kitchen department, somebody is DT department, temple management, and there is people who care of preaching, transportation department, devotee care department, guest care ticket taking department, devotee care. But there are two important departments without which any ISKCON will not work. Do you know what are the two departments? Without these are the fundamental basic two departments without which any, it could be a small center or it's a big center. At least I'm talking about the small center. Let's say there is a new center which is starting. These are the two basic function department should have. Huh? Okay. Another one? Maybe, may not be.
Cleaning, Prabhu.
Let's say small center. You may not have DTs. Yeah, Krishna kingdom is here, right? KK, kitchen and kirtan. If any devotees, we see Prabhupada Leelamrita, right? The devotees just go out of Harinam. They distribute some prasadam or book. Then they are happy. So that way we can see this. The tongue can be controlled only by prasadam, eating Krishna prasadam, and by doing japa or hearing. So in order to hear, your tongue should chant this holy name. If these two things are done perfectly, then other things will fall in place. Other things should support this, basically, your chanting or meditation. The DT is beautifully decorated. That should add up to your chanting. When you do your seva, you will be able to do happily. So all this kirtanam, hearing it, purifying our senses, that should add up to all our devotion service. Sometimes you might do only seva, seva. There are people really good at doing seva, but they may not be really as good as in the sadhana. Because there's somebody is looking at, I'm doing it, somebody is appreciating it. Even though it's devotion service, somebody might be attracted to the seva. They might be do wonderful seva. But similarly, when we are not able to control our tongue, jiva, we are not able to hear properly, then there's seva aparada happens, Vaishnava aparada happens, and slowly, gradually, they might fall down. So it's very important that we give importance to this jiva, especially kirtan, especially japa, personal chanting. Then we realize the holy name of the Lord. Here we were striking purport, Prabhupada writes, even you can't understand the holy name. I said form qualities, it's fine. Pastimes also, it's fine. But he says Krishna's holy name also you can't understand unless you purify your senses. That was really striking for me to understand. So having said that, I said the mood on which we perform this seva, that's very important than the seva itself. So we can hear from this one realization which is happening last 2 weeks back. I was thinking like that, supporting the local temple, local yatra. Sometimes, you know, I used to hear Bhagavatam, Nitya Bhagavata Saya. After that, I was on and off. Then I thought, okay, let me, you know, hear some senior lectures, somebody senior, you know, other temples, what's happening, and, you know, like that. Sometime, oh, we might choosy, saying that, oh, this is devotee speaking, so let me skip it. Let me hear something else. We might do the choosing a particular speaker that might be keep happening it. So how we need to understand that a bhakti can comes from only bhakta. Devotion can come from only a devotee. Even if you go and pray to Krishna, Krishna give me a devotion service, pure love for Godhead, Krishna cannot give, because even he doesn't know how to love himself, right? You are asking Krishna, I want to love you, tell me how to love you. Krishna, he won't want to experience. He became as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the Radharani's mood. He want to enjoy what is the love for him. He has to come as a Radharani mood of Radharani to enjoy himself. So if you go and ask Krishna, give me devotion service, he might inspire, but he through medium is that bhakta. Unless bhakta gives, Krishna even cannot give you directly a bhakti. He has to give through his representative, either guru or a pure Vaishnava. And we never know, the bhakta need not be necessarily a great sannyasi, or it could be a siksha guru. It could be any person who's sitting on the vyasas, and it can happen like that. For example, when we are seeing this Bilvamangala Thakur, he was so attracted to that prostitute. His father was died. He did not do Antya Samskara. He was running. It was raining heavily. He was catching hold of a dead body. He was crossing the river, then catching hold of a snake, thinking as a rope, climbing. Then the prostitute told, as you are doing it, you could have utilized for Krishna's service. How that would have been? That was actually his guru speaking through this Vani, through speaking this prostitute. He did not think that is, sometime we might hear saying that, okay, I've been... no, this is not a body. It might looks like a basic a speaker might be speaking, you're not the soul, we need to do a devotion service, follow four regulative principle. It might look simple, but sometimes the spark can hit you. We never know who is going to spark that. So the guru can act via medium through the bhakta. So the bhakta can only give bhakti. There is no one else can give bhakti, even including Krishna. So what happened, this spark of bhakti, guru has spoken through this medium of the prostitute, Bilvamangala Thakur got bewildered and he became a devotee. So this realization happened last week when I was listening to one of the lectures. This devotee has mentioned that if you don't chant extra round, there is no extra, I mean, you're not trying endeavor for Krishna's mercy, or there's no Krishna's mercy. That's why he could be able to chant only 16 rounds, not more. Then I suddenly wrote to my group saying that tomorrow we are chanting 64. They all bewildered. Why suddenly he's telling 64 rounds? They don't know. But this is the inspiration. When I heard this, it has struck me really. I've heard many times people telling you have to chant minimum 16 rounds, Prabhupada told. Many a times they told, but it may not spark. But suddenly you might be hearing some person. Then suddenly Krishna might enthuse. Then I said, today onwards, we are chanting 64 rounds. Another 2 days like that. Then we chanted 64 rounds. Let me chant another. I made endeavor. So far, I never made endeavor to chant extra round, only on the festival days. But regularly, let me add at least one round. I started doing it because this is inspirational. Anybody can give inspiration. A bhakta is speaking about, it is not the person who is sitting on the Vyasasan. It is the person, what is the matter, is subject matter is talking about. It is talking about Srimad Bhagavatam. Is representing Srila Prabhupada. Is representing the Guru Parampara. He is talking the same words what the Lord is speaking. So when they speak, we can introspect how much I am able to follow this, how much I am able to relate to this. It not necessarily need to be a thing. What I'm trying to, the point I'm making is that the supporting the local yatra, the local devotees, is very important. Sometimes we think that, okay, this I can skip, you know, who cares about it, let me do something else, or try to go with other things also important, listening to other senior Vaishnava is important. I'm not saying that you should neglect it, but not neglecting at the cost of local. We get our enthusiasm when we come to Sunday temple, we see the deities, we take our inspiration from the local yatras. We would have come from various yatras, we might still attach to the original yatra, not a problem. But when we come here, our inspiration happens here. The temple construction happens here. There is a deity greeting happens here. We talk to each other. We have to also encourage the devotees here. So what happens is, imagine there is no problem in speaker in our temple. There are a lot of people who can give class, but people who will attend. Sometime back, I remember when we were doing this Bhagavatam, Nitya Bhagavata Sevya, they'll put a chart for who will attend the class, because the devotee would come. Some of them are office and other problems I have. They really don't have time to sit in the class. That's why we shifted the timing to 6:30 to 7, 7:30, something like that, before the deity greeting. So that's so people can assemble. Sometime in Bhakti Varsha, I would have invited thousands of new devotees. I don't know who will turn up. Even one person turn up, I will tell all my Bhakta leaders saying that you need to log in. Because even one soul comes, he will see there is only one person, he might go away. At least you are 4 or 5 people log in, we can have a discussion. I ensure that they log in. Even though it is same topic, I'm going to talk about them, same basic preaching I'm going to do. I ensure that. Sometimes people think I'm insignificant. If I don't log in, what will happen? I don't come to the class, what will happen? So this is an inspiration when we see the devotees. You are trying to help the other devotees to grow, progress, because they are trying to purify themselves. They are telling that I want to follow this. They're sitting in Vyasasana, committing. They want to purify themselves. So encouraging the local yatra, local devotees, encouraging each other, whatever difficulty it is there. This is very, very important. The mood in which a person performs the seva, that is important than the seva itself. Somebody might do a wonderful seva elsewhere, but you need to see, take care of the local yatra as well. That is also very, very important. I was listening recently to Prabhupada Katha. This one Mataji, Ananga Manjari Mataji. She was talking about her realization. This was the first day she is visiting the temple. The next day, she has been made to Sankirtan leader. He said, tomorrow onwards, you're distributing Bhagavad Gita. Back to Godhead. She said, I didn't know anything about it. Then he said, no, whatever you know, you tell it. So she went on saying that she knows only Satchit Ananda, eternal bliss, knowledge. She's just telling the three words again. Then there was a person who is in the community, with the hippies. They heard bliss. Then he said, what is bliss? She said, it's better than LSD. No, that's all. They got it, attracted to it. And she came first Sunday. This is the first Sunday she is coming to the temple. She wants to know more about philosophy. Then asked devotees, how do I speak like you? How do I know absolute truth? You just listen, then you can preach. Then she attended only one session of Prabhupada Sunday. It was very late in the night. She started going. The devotees dropped off her in the bus stop because it was very late. She was young, 16, 17. Then she had these flowers offered to the Lord in her hand. And she had this Gopi Chandan, because the devotees, when they come to the temple, they put the tilak. And they gave some incense stick, say, carry on with you. Then she was sitting in the bus with Agarbatti. There is a flower, tilak. Then she doesn't know. She started chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Then there was a strange person, Indian, looked at the particular Mataji saying, what is she doing it? And he was saying, strangely looking at this Mataji, like that. She was feeling embraced. And she wanted to get down off the bus. As soon as he stopped, she wanted to run away to the railway station. She started running and this person started chasing. Then, madam, madam, then she finally begged, bowed on, saying that, I never seen any foreigner who taking Krishna consciousness so interesting. I have learned Krishna from my birth, but I never seen somebody taking. And she started preaching 20 minutes to the person. Here is the person who came first week, first time to the temple, heard Prabhupada for 2 hours, and she started lecturing for 20 minutes to the other Indian person who knows about Krishna consciousness philosophy. It is the mood on which they did. So then the person said, do you want to have coffee? And she said, no, I don't drink coffee. It is just entering into the movement. Imagine the Western world, how Prabhupada, they empowered them. They just simply, they've taken Prabhupada. Whatever message given, they have taken it. And this Mataji, after some time, they decided, after 1 year, 6 months of marriage, Prabhupada said, anything best, you have to give it to Krishna. Then they said, what is the best we can give? We can give ourselves. He told his husband, you go and become a sannyasi. I will also go for preaching. Let's go to Prabhupada and confirm. And they went to Prabhupada, paid obeisances. Prabhupada said, so? He said, we have read that in your books that people go to the brahmachari. They join the temple less than 6-8 months. Then they take grahastha, then they take sannyas. Now we have done that, we want to take sannyas. And Prabhupada was laughing and said, are you sure your wife is okay? The wife said, yes, yes, I'm okay. I'm happy to get him sannyas. So like that, we see the sincerity of them. They don't have any philosophy. That time Prabhupada wrote only Bhagavatam, trying to print Bhagavad Gita. Still he was trying to translate Chaitanya Charitamrita. There's not much philosophy. But the simple Krishna conscious, the message of the Harinam, the holy name, the power, the mood in which they carry out. Prabhupada sometime would say, okay, you are temple president of New York, LA, then you are president of Montreal. Then Isolde Jayapath Kamara said, there is no temple in Montreal, Prabhupada. Yes, yes, you go and establish and you become temple president. Prabhupada is so transcendental and they had that faith. They simply carried out Prabhupada. For Prabhupada, they can do anything. But the mood in which they did the seva is very important. Temples, before even writing so many volumes of book, becoming a philosopher, preacher, Prabhupada was not able to spend time with all of the temple. He was traveling. See, the beauty of the thing is that it is not on the service. The mood on which they could able to take the service and propagate the faith on which they had in Prabhupada, that is stood out than the seva itself. Sometimes we might do very wonderful service because Krishna has naturally given the skill. So some you might outperform somebody that really attracts Krishna. No, somebody might just sweep the floor. Somebody just put water the plant, as simple as that. Krishna maybe, he can inspire. The bhakti can come through another bhakta. We never know it's a junior bhakta, senior bhakta, anybody sincere. We can't measure the bhakti. So it is very important that we hear from everyone. and also supporting this, because here is where we get encouraged with each other, supporting the local yatra. That's really important. That's I had this strong realization. Then I started regularly hearing it, at least offline. If I'm not able to make it, then I would hear all the lectures offline. So that's something, and I want to tell the devotees, because at least I would follow. If I tell them sitting here, then I would try to follow this, which I wanted to follow. So like that, there are many pastimes of Prabhupada. I can talk about it. We have seen that one time Prabhupada saying the mood on which Prabhupada sees utility is the principle. There is one big rock music, the album they were trying to produce, and they were showing to Prabhupada, and it was really rock Hare Krishna Maha Mantra or something in the English word, also poem also they've written, they're trying to sing. Prabhupada could not able to follow. Then said, what is that he's trying to say? Prabhupada is telling that is, you're not the body or the soul. Okay. And Prabhupada listened to the entire album. Then they were, Prabhupada asked, who is singing? Is that Vishnujan singing? The devotee said, yes, Prabhupada. No problem. Whoever is listens Vishnujan, they'll go back to Godhead. Prabhupada encouraged, they see the, Prabhupada did not say, oh, it is Western guys, you are always thinking about hard rock music, passionate music. He didn't discourage them. He said, okay, that's good, you carry on. Sometime Prabhupada also seen that some devotees made Narsinga album, very heavy guitar and, you know, Namaste Narsingaya in different form. And Prabhupada was listening to them and he was tapping with his cane, trying to do the beat. Then he smiled bigly. He said, you are better than the Beatles. He's just trying to encourage every devotee, whatever skill they have, the devotion which they perform. Prabhupada never saw, you know, you are a Western mentality is like that. You guys always do like this. He never criticized, but rather encouraged. He saw the devotion on which they did for Prabhupada, because they do everything for Prabhupada. They live off their family life. They give up everything and they just depend on Prabhupada. So that mood on which even the simple seva they're trying to do, it is given the result, tremendous result. That's because Krishna is very pleased with the mood of devotion, not the service itself. So like that, there are many points, but I would like to stop here for more comments or questions. Before that, I'll just quickly summarize what we have seen it. We have seen that Prabhupada is in this sloka telling that we only purified senses, seeing Krishna face to face through the tongue, especially prasadam, chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. These are the two important processes. If you control your tongue, other senses automatically will control. That's where we have seen the various pramanas available in the Shastras, especially Jiva Goswami from Tattva Sandarpa. There are 10 pramanas available. Then we have seen our eyes are, you know, then we are also seeing examples of various devotees, how they see the Lord. Rather, we should try to make ourselves so that the Lord can see us. Then also we have discussed about Atha Shri Krishna Nama Adi. Seven Mukehi Jivadu, how this is very important, and seva itself not important. Also, it is important on which the mood on which we perform our seva, encouraging the local devotees, whatever the service they are trying to do, supporting each other. That's very, very important. That's where we grow. That's where I stop here. Please forgive me if there are any offenses. I've spoken anything which is appropriate, inappropriate. I would now request for more reflection and comments. Any question or comments? Any audience from the Zoom online? You can put it in the chat or you can unmute yourself.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. I don't know whether you're able to hear me. Gochana Gopinath Prabhu, are you able to hear us? Okay, maybe I'll put
it. Please go ahead, Prabhu. No problem. You please go ahead. I can just repeat to him. I'm in the time.
Okay. So,
meanwhile, I can tell you one more pastime. By the time you can post your question. So this Mataji was trying to get a second initiation. and they don't know how to pronounce this Gayatri mantra, and they did never give a slip of paper with this mantra. So she went to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada was sitting in front of her and said, okay, you repeat after me. Then Prabhupada started doing this Gayatri mantra. This Mataji could not able to even continue 2-3 sentences, 2-3 words. Then Prabhupada said, never mind. Then he said, I will arrange somebody to give you in the paper, piece of paper, this mantra, you can memorize it. So Prabhupada never so that Prabhupada said, he seen that devotion of those sincere soul who are trying to do that, rather than if they are not able to chant, he did not chastise them. So he see how Prabhupada was accommodative and seeing only seeing the devotion on those person who are trying to serve him. That's another important thing which we can learn from Prabhupada. And we also know that Prabhupada is to cook and wash all the plates. He do only two things. Even though he speaks initially the philosophy, he would do 1.5 hour kirtan, and then followed by smart short lecture. Again, he do 1.5 hour kirtan. Then he give big feast, and people would eat and throw the plates and go. And Prabhupada is to clean up himself. So that's why the kitchen and kirtan is very important. Prabhupada focused more on kirtan. They know that they have to be purified their senses. Once they purified, they are able to listen. Then they were able to give up their life for Prabhupada. So that starts with Sevan Mukhehi Jivahadu. Okay, comments from Sankarshan Priya Prabhu.
I'm just going to read out. Is it Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, wonderful class, especially two points. The devotion can come only through a devotee, and the importance of supporting the local yatra. I felt them to be inspiring for me. Thank you very much, Prabhu.
Hari Bol.
Okay. One more question.
I can read out if you want to.
Yeah, Hare Krishna Prabhuji, wonderful class Prabhuji. Mood in which we should our service really start. But sometime we take pride in service and become carried away with that. How we can come out of this? So one thing is that the service, how do you do it? There are two ways to do the service. I was chanting long time. I was striving, really conscious, making effort. But I was hearing to this japa retreat. Then I heard from another devotee that for the pleasure of Krishna you chant, rather than you are striving yourself. Again, you are centralized yourself, saying that I am chanting, I want to get purified, I want to reduce my pride, I am trying this, I want to control my senses, I want to really achieve love of Godhead. Then you try to chant. Sometimes it doesn't work. So when you chant for the pleasure of Krishna, then entire things changes differently. As I mentioned, you know, the Lord will see us beautifully and let us nicely dress. When we do seva also, it is for the pleasure of the Lord. I am doing this seva for the pleasure of Lord. When you remove it saying, I am doing this seva, then this pride and other things can come into picture. But always you keep Krishna saying that I am doing this for the pleasure of the devotees, I am doing this for the pleasure of the Lord, then the attitude itself changes. Then most of the time you have chances of not committing these offenses. Second thing is that always having Vaishnava association, thinking that we are the just instrument, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam regularly, understanding again and then again that we are just instrument, Krishna is great. Then as we understand more about Krishna, when we go closer, Krishna is great, then you feel that you are really insignificant. So reading Srimad Bhagavatam gives that idea. When he creates the Brahmanda, then you realize, how Krishna is powerful. Then he tries to kill so many demons. You read every day Krishna book, then you realize, Krishna is so powerful. Then you feel very, very insignificant. And you hear about the glories of Bhagavatam, the devotees, Parikshit Maharaj and other people, you feel insignificant. So you should feel insignificant. Then you will not commit offenses. So reading Srimad Bhagavatam is another thing. One is that doing for Krishna. I am doing this seva for Krishna. Second thing, I am being just an instrument. These two things can keep away from the pride. Last week in the devotee care, we are discussing modes of material nature. And this one should go beyond this modes of material nature. Anything related to Krishna, it is transcendental. It is beyond this modes of material nature. It can purify. It's just that we are in the modes and we are not able to come out. We can still sit in the temple hall, think about something materially. That's possible. But this is Vaikuntha. We are in Vaikuntha. We are serving the Lord. There is no difference between Vaikuntha and the temple hall. In the temple, when we are here, the Lord is there. Any activity, anything connected to Krishna is beyond this modes of material nature. Whether we are able to perceive or not, it depends on that. So what happens slowly, gradually, when we are in touch with the transcendental mechanically, though we do mechanically, definitely it will give a realization, but we also need to endeavor to understand that. And definitely this is a transcendental activity. Definitely it purifies after a prolonged time, but it will be good by hearing the knowledge, associating with the devotees, with understanding. When we do that, not mechanically, the faster the progress. Of course, it's a transcendental activity. Even though you do mechanically, it will give results in longer run. Okay, today afternoon 3 p.m. there is a Bhakti Shastri orientation program. Srila Prabhupada ki. Those who are interested to this course can attend this meeting. Zoom details will be sent on WhatsApp groups. This is another announcement. Srila Prabhupada ki. It's very, very important to study this Bhakti courses very seriously. Prabhupada always said somebody need to scrutinously study the Shastras. This is the opportunity in ICC for the devotees. I kindly urge everyone to take opportunity of this course and register yourself. And Narayari Prabhu is great. Narayari Chaitanya Prabhu will be addressing this meeting. Hari Bol. So I have forwarded to all my groups. I've inspired other devotees to take up this. So please, you can also inspire your family, friends, anybody who wants to be serious in understanding Prabhupada books. It can transform many lives. It has transformed many lives. So if you are really serious about not doing this sadhana or the devotion service mechanically, this is the answer. We want to do in the mode of seva. You want to develop that mode. This is the place where you can learn how to do this. Anything you want to add, Swarna Gaurari Prabhu? Yeah. Yeah, what he is asking, what is group property? Sometime, you know, some devotees we have seen that they take extreme vrata, very, very, you know, paining to the body. Sometime they don't take care of the body. Today, Narayari Prabhu was advising me, how should I maintain my body? Because this belongs to the guru, seva, this seva, like I need to serve the Vaishnavas. I can't take that. Okay, it's my body. I can do whatever with I want. So there should be certain extent that devotee care needs to be taken care, because this is the property of the Lord. We need to see that I belongs to Krishna. When I got initiated, I belongs to Guru. I belongs to Krishna. So whatever they want, I need to perform. So is that we should not be very careless about our taking care of the health, and also always in the mood that I am always belong to Krishna. So whenever I do perform my service or sadhana, then I know that I am being just instrument in the service of the Lord. So taking of the property means as soon as we take initiation, this body is the soul and body is not belongs to us. It belongs to the Guru. Guru can tell you, okay, you do this seva. I want you to go and preach to the particular place. Then we should be ready to go. If Guru says, no, you have to do this particular seva, it is even though difficult, you don't want to do it, you have to be ready. And like Prabhupada, I was mentioning, right? Everybody is ready. They don't know. They said, Prabhupada, you go to China. You said, you go to that country, this country. They surrender themselves to Prabhupada. Unless somebody says, no, Prabhupada says you go, then you might say, come back, say, Prabhupada, I can't go, I can't speak that language, I don't know the philosophy, I'm just 6 months old in the movement, I'm just 1 year old in the movement. No, they said, okay, Prabhupada is telling, I belongs to Prabhupada. So this Mataji was telling that even though the husband and wife, they married, husband used to live in the ashram and Mataji used to live in their ashram. They never used to have a family life, even though just married for the sake of marriage. But they were working like a god brother and sister. They were trying to preach Prabhupada's mission. So when she went and approached Prabhupada for sannyas, they didn't have any problem because they thought that they belong to Prabhupada. Their properties belongs to Prabhupada. Anything best we need to give to Prabhupada. Look at the mood on which they have surrendered. So when I say that this body belongs to Prabhupada, this belongs to this mission, This belongs to the Guru. We try to at most try to use it in the seva rather than the personal use, and we should not think and neglect also our personal care, because we think that it's my body, I can do whatever I want. No, there should be some responsibility towards your health as well, so that you can perform devotional service nicely, and you know, you can do seva for your Guru. I was telling that example of the story. The person lost his eyes, but he was hesitant to ask the Lord, give me the eyes back, because he thought it's personal. Anyabhileshasudhanyam. He thought it's something material. But Ramanuja knows that it's not something material. Then he told, you belongs to me. You are my property. Now you go and pray to the Lord, saying that property of my Lord is something damaged. So my Guru is damaged. You give me, fix that. Then he got his eyes back. Understanding that we always think that we always belongs to the Guru. Then take care of things properly, including the property. It could be anything. Everything belongs to Krishna. Then we try to handle it. Sometimes we do seva. Some devotees come, they are very enthused, and they just drag it and make a scratch in the floor, or they break it, something, they go. When we realize that, oh, this is, I'm doing it for Krishna seva, let me handle it carefully. This is Krishna's property, let me handle it carefully. Then that time automatically the mood will be completely different. A person who is saying, I am doing this seva, look at me, I'm going to decorate this temple. He'll climb up and down. He might do something. He might fall up something. Then he might break something. That is there means that he is doing it. He wants to do it. Rather, I say, I want to go to do it for Prashara, Prabhupada, and I'm doing it for the deities. You imagine the same service how the person will do. He will do differently. He will never do like that. So that's what it means. Okay. Anything else on the chat? It's 9:58. Hare Krishna. So thank you so much. Again, I ask for forgiveness if I have anything I have spoken inappropriate beyond my capacity. And just a reminder for 3 p.m. Zoom meeting, please attend. If you are not, right now you are not decided also, that's fine. You should attend this meeting so that you get more information about this course. Then you can decide, but I would urge all of you to attend this course without fail. Thank you very much. Grandhraj Srimad Bhavadam ki.
Jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Jai Gaur Premanande.
Hari Hari Bol. Dandavat Pranams Prabhu.
Dandavat Pranams Prabhu. Hare Krishna.